Good day, fellas. This is your daily dose of skill. And what we are going to talk about today, since marathon is over and majority of us is on the full mode, because let's be real right here, a lot of people was playing way more than usual just to get extra 10 or 20% for a discount of the list marathon, right? And I decided to revisit this tank. I decided to play once again with it and to say, is it worth it or is it not worth as a vehicle? I just had a warming up round with this vehicle. I did 2000 damage, 600 assisting damage, but once again, that's only warming up, right? Overall, my experience with this tank, I met a lot of lists in the battlefield, and what I noticed that majority of the people is playing properly with this vehicle. What do I mean by saying that? Looking into the standard ammunition and into the gold ammunition, look at the penetration, look into the shell velocity, majority of the people is spamming gold with this vehicle, right? So this is the right way to play with a tank, right? If that makes sense. For us fellas, we was using for majority of the time improved equipment, right here, bounty equipment and stabilizer. We have quite some gold shells, but I'm trying to shoot as many standard as physically possible. Obviously, if the tier 10 matchmaking is coming and we are aiming for a bloody mouse or something else, then we are going into the gold, right? And overall, we managed to get a performance of 2500 damage and 900 assisting damage, which is, in my opinion, great. It is very, very nice. And this tank, if you like, fellas, the quick opinion about this tank. If you like T-44, you will like the Liss AK Fox, right? You are going to enjoy it. That's it, fellas. And obviously, I will give you 2 to 3 games with this vehicle. And after that, skill is going to sleep. Currently, it is 5 in the morning when I'm recording this video. As you can see, amount of the people playing the game is very, very low, but it's completely fine. It is understandable, right? And I will try to show you the best what I can do with this tank, right? Matchmaking during those hours is going to be quite shitty, but in the same time, that's good, because I will try to show you how this vehicle is performing when matchmaking is the worst, right? What you can do. Speaking about the armor of the tank, armor is not very, very good, my lovely friends. It's just not. Speaking about the gun handling and everything, I would say this is very, very, very good. This is very, very, very good vehicle. Compare that as an example with a FV4202. This is like a day and night. With a FV, you are going to miss the shots. With this vehicle, you are going to hit majority of them. But once again, gold is the right way to play with this vehicle. And probably you are thinking, is it worth it to buy with a 50% off or 80% off, or however you manage it to get. So fellas, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, only you can tell this, right? Tank itself is not game changer, it's not game damaging. I don't really think it's like, you know, bad tank or good tank. I think it's very, very strong vehicle, but it's not even close as being good as Progetto. Probably I would keep compare this tank to the T-44-100. That's what I would do. Obviously, this tank have just tiny touch better alpha damage, right? So here you go. And obviously, fellas, to make stuff easier for us, for everyone, to be fair with you, feel free to share your opinion in the comment section down below. So if people is having a discount and they are not sure, do they want to spend their 12, 18 or 24 bucks or however much you got of the discount, right? Feel free to share your opinion and to say, is it worth it or it's not really worth it? That's the main goal right there, right? Okay, so far, Once again, let's speak about this. What do we have over there? We have quite bad matchmaking for us, and the map is definitely not looking even close for being great. But you know what? We are not going to give up. I have a feeling enemy Ferrari should be over there. So let's check it out, and Ferrari is right there. We are penetrating him with a high explosive straight into the face, which is completely fine. And we will try to eliminate him from the game just now. Beautiful. Very, very nice. So far we did everything properly. And even though we got penetrated by Ferrari with a high explosive, so the penetration wasn't too high, right? Okay, look, so far everything is looking okay-ish. I cannot say we are sitting in huge shithole over there, okay? At least that's what I think. I think we are kind of fine. But what we want to do, we want to figure out how to defend the base, because this is going to be very, very, very important thing, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen. This is going to be super important thing. So as you can see, enemy VK is going down, and that's exactly what we want to see. Since he is going down, we should be able to penetrate his side of the turret, or maybe even upper plate, if the angle is going to be just great for us, right? That's the main plan, that's the main dream. And obviously, as you can see, enemies have many, I repeat, many forces which is going and making hardcore pressure like this. So what we want to do, we want to kind of escape from over there before it's too late. 5100 was trying to cut our way here, but he obviously failed. And what we can do meanwhile, we have a very good position towards him, so we can smack him once or twice, right? I had quite some APCRs because the distance between me and enemies was quite humongous, right? So I believe that's completely understandable. And what we need to do now, we need to defend the base, my friends. We must defend the base. I must admit I am quite disappointed. Our E100 is kind of clueless pigeon, and he is just pushing in front instead of defending base over there, right? But I don't really know what I supposed to do about that. This E100 is a tourist. Let it be. Let him go in front. And what do we have now? We have this CS63 over there, which will try to defend the base, I guess. Well, someone will try to cap the base, and he will try to help the person which is capping the base over there, which is kind of fine. Now look, this E100, he have shit ton of the hit points right there, okay? He have so many hit points over there, it's kind of crazy. And unlucky, I am getting lit on fire. Oh well, what can we do? Look at the bright side, at least we managed to get a decent shot right there. All good, everything is fine. So in this kind of situation, fellas, I think we got as much use as we physically and possibly could. I decided to go for a base def. Maybe that was quite a big misplay from my side. So maybe I could sit around this area and, try to support this some YSM which was right here. But you know what? It is completely fine. No complaints, no regrets. I am simply accepting what I'm having and, better luck next time. Right? Either way, this battle wasn't the super balanced as usual. The score is 6-12, but I must admit I've seen the shitter scores over there, right? And we have like 3 guys alive, 2 slow teddy bears, which is E3, and the MX5100 probably shredding him with APCR ammunition, and there is a T95 which is trying to support him, but it's a matter of the time when this guy is going to get slaughtered too. Why so skill? The answer is simple. The T-55A is going from his ass already. And once again, enemies simply have way too many forces in order. And for T-95 to win, probably he needs to have some kind of nuclear fart, I would say, if he wants to win. Although that's quite smart decision from his side to try to deal with the T-55A, and he will. miss the shot. Ay ay ay. Hashtag never lucky. Okay, so as a first battle, fellas, once again, that's not horrible, that's not bad by any means, and we managed to pick up a decent score considering what kind of matchmaking and what kind of battle we had. We can actually call this average performance. 2,500 damage and 800 assisting damage. That's okay. Here you go. Obviously, if we would shoot majority of the APCRs, I believe we could pick up one or two extra shots right here, but yeah, I don't really mind. Fellas, I have a very, very simple logic when I'm playing the game myself, right? And my logic is, if I am not forced to shoot gold, I am not shooting gold. And with this performance, we are getting 42,000 profits, not taking into consideration I am using bread with Smalik and I have a shit ton of them in the storage, right? So yeah. So I should count minus 10,000, so it would be 30,000 profits, but that's okay. Anyways, what do we have right here? We have Harry Potter map. Obviously, we are not going to run the Harry Potter for a YouTube video, but you get the point what I'm saying. And but once again, the tier 10 matchmaking, this is very, very, very late morning or, very early morning or late night. So once again, matchmaking is not going to be epic. Matchmaking is not going to be awesome. And I believe that's completely understandable, right? But once again, instead of waking up earlier tomorrow, I thought, why not to make a video later on? And fellas, quick information for you, I had lazy Sunday, I was chilling, I was doing nothing. We were spending quite a bit of time with my girl, and it was very, very good time. And I can tell you that, fellas, this marathon damaged my brain a little bit, right? As an example, Saturday stream went quite bad. I don't know, maybe that was because of the internet, or maybe that was because of the marathon itself, right? But the main thing what I'm trying to say right here is I needed to take a bit of the rest. And I can tell you one very, very important thing, my friends. If you are feeling you need to take a rest from the game, don't hesitate. Just simply take a break for 1, 2, 3 days or whatever, and just simply recover your strength, because you will come back stronger and you will feel so much better. I can promise you that, fellas. I learned that from my experience myself. Anyways, what we are trying to do right here, boys and girls, our main mission is to try to shoot whoever is getting spotted right here. In this kind of situation, we have enemy E100 over there, and we have so many bushwankers right here. This is actually insane. So what is our goal? Obviously, we want to have quite some APCRs for obvious reasons, right? APCRs is necessary dealing with the tanks with the big meatballs like E100 or E3, right? So I believe I did not surprise at any single of you. And right here, we will simply try to wait until enemies will make one or another stupidity, one or another mistake, right? Simple. So all we need to do, we need to be patient. What is the worst thing for us? I would say the worst thing for us is enemies have a lot of forces in the middle, and we don't really have them. I mean, as you can see yourself, we have way too many guys in the 1-2 line, but in the same time, until the ELC 90 is over there, to be fair with you, that's half of the trouble. Unless our team will decide to go super aggressively over there, then it would be not so good. Anyways, we managed to spot the T-55A right here, which is completely fine. That's great. Now look. I'm trying to make a decision which is going to lead us for a victory. That's the question. What I want to do. I think patience is going to be the key. I don't really think I can make a hardcore pressure over there, at least I don't want to believe that, and as you can see, we are not spotting anyone which is over there, so yeah, that's a bit of a shame, but that's okay. Look, since we did not get enough use, or we didn't get any use whatsoever from the 1-2 line by trying to spot them, What is going to be our mission here? We will try to shoot people which is playing on top of the hill, right? And we are going to start everything with the blind shots right here. I assume, no blind shots needed because this guy is being way too aggressive, and this is exactly what we wanted to see. And as you can see, this this conqueror shed his pants quite a bit. Good, very, very good. That's what we want to see, right? Wait for it, fellas. We have all time in the world of tanks. Simply wait until he is going to make another mistake. Because if this guy is moving up, we are definitely hitting him. Also, you know what? I have an idea. Before everything, boys, how about if I am trying to spot people over there, right? I believe we can definitely do that. Wait a second. And unfortunately, I did not manage to spot and I lost majority of my hit points. Okay, there is no medicine from stupidity, fellas. That was quite silly move from my side, and I deserved everything what I got here. But that's okay. I know what I deserved and I know what I have made over there. That T-55A spotted me very, very well. And just because that guy spotted me, I took quite a bit for the team, and now I am pretty much down to fartable. So what that pretty much means, whenever I'm going to make a mistake, that mistake is going to be critical. But that's okay, relax, we got this. Look, the saddest part of all this is our team lost a lot of hit points over there, and that's kind of a pity thing. But once again, not much what we can do right there. How about if, our spotter just died. Our hope and our spotter just died. I have an idea. How about if we are going to completely relocate from over there, right? My biggest fear is this T-55A, eventually he is going to say F this shit and he will simply go YOLO on me and it's going to be end of the battle. And you know what, fellas? I'm not ready to finish the game yet. I still want to get a couple thousand of damage, and hopefully it's going to be the case. Meanwhile, E-100 is getting spotted via the 500 meters distance, and I am trying to aim for his lower plate over there. We should be fine, fellas. And trying to kill him, unfortunately that wasn't the kill, but that's okay. E-100 died. Score is 4-4, which is always good and always welcome. And once again, we have quite some things to do, right? What happened over there? This T-55A eliminated our UDES, which was sitting in extremely powerful bush. So what we will do now? We will get into this bush ourselves and we will try to play against that T-55A, which is sitting over there, right? This is going to be the main plan and the main hope for us. So if this guy is doing something silly, we are going to punish him. Although the gun handling said, skill, how about no? That was a bit sad, but once again, we can't change it. Patience. I have seen better battles in this map, but once again, I lost like 800 hit points for free here, so I simply cannot complain with my decisions and with the score which we have right now, right? So once again, and this is actually a very, very good showcase. Now you might think, but skill, why so? The thing is, fellas, when with this vehicle you are bottom tier, right? This is exactly the gameplay which you are going to have. You are going to snipe from the back and you are going to have so much, you will have a chilled gaming experience, right? Your main goal is going to be to punish enemies whenever they are going to make one or another mistake. Now, if you will be super aggressive with this vehicle, even though on the paper you have like 200mm of armor frontally, right? I'm speaking about the turret. Believe me, majority of the tier 8s will be able to penetrate you without gold whatsoever. And obviously you can flex on the lower tiers like tier 6s or tier 7s, which overall have a smaller base penetration, right? So yeah, patience, wait for it. Mm-hmm. I missed that shot. I could definitely punish this T55A before, but mistakes were made. But that's completely fine. 6 minutes left of the battle. We are just chilling. We are simply chilling and waiting until he will mess up. And this is a matter of the time, fellas, because in my opinion, this guy should start making pressure like this. He got punished for once, and now, since he is down to one shotable, he is going to be so much more responsible for his peekings. Although, as you can see, our team is kind of getting slaughtered over there. Now, look. This T55A, he is never ever going to get spotted again, because our standard B is simply too far away. Our object is also, you know, having a safe defense parameter. So that's definitely not what we want to have, but it is how it is. Okay, how about if we would relocate a bit like this? Now you might think, Skill, what this relocation is going to give for you? This relocation, fellas, we should be able to help our guys if the statue or this MX5100 is making a hardcore pressure in front. That's the main point of me being here. And this position over there is simply not valuable anymore, at least in my eyes. And if I feel like this is simply not worth it for us to play there, I am not playing there. By the way, speaking about the good things, there is a Progetto which is making a mistake. And obviously, for me, my main mission over there will be to try to shoot him as many times as I can. Also, he is doing some kind of dick move right there. What do I mean by saying that is, he's trying to hide behind his Borshik, right? Which is overall not very, very nice thing from the Progetto side. Since he has so much more hit points and he is more powerful as a tank itself, but you know, who can blame him? He wants to survive longer, and you know, not much what we can change right here. Anyways, fellas, looks like this battle is coming to an end. Sad story. Not much what we can do about this. This is probably the game over for our battle. Now look. By the looks of it, enemy team was quite a bit stronger than our team was, and they managed to pick up a very, very, very great score, and they played well in my eyes. In my opinion, fellas, they played well. Obviously, before dying, fellas, we will be able to do one or another free shot right here, to the left, to the right, and so on, right? And this is the main goal for us. Maybe we can get one or two more shots over there. Now look, I do not have the gold ammunition left. I simply can't do anything for this E3. But what I can do, I can simply wait until this T55A will try to go more aggressive towards us. If he is going to go more aggressive towards us, we should be able to pick up the kill. Or maybe there is another victim which is going straight towards us, and here we go, another shot. That's good, fellas. Look, we managed to get solid 3,200 damage and 1,000 assisting / tracking damage, and in this kind of fate, in this kind of situation, it was a great battle in my opinion. Once again, enemies had a stronger team, they did things better. Who is the main players in the enemy team? In my opinion, guys which played on the hill did great. Guys which played in the middle did great, and they had a spotter in the one line which was either the Progetto or either a Borshik. Let's see. So what do we have right here? Star 2, which was playing in on top of the hill, if I'm not mistaken, right? 5100 was playing in the middle. E3 went super aggressively towards the one line, and I assume they should have a spotter somewhere, but probably I was incorrect. Also, that T55A did quite a great job, 2.7 thousand assisting damage. Great performance by him. Anyways. this. We have a defeat and we managed to get 39,000 credits. Why such a low credit income skill? Because I was shooting quite some gold ammunition. And I'm telling you, against the lower tiers, you don't really need gold unless you want to be more predictable accuracy-wise. Speaking about the higher tiers, obviously you need to tap that 2 key if you want to be semi-competitive, right? And this is the income which you have. So in those two battles, we managed to get 3,000 damage and 1,000 assisting damage, which is great score in my opinion. So fellas, in the end of the day, you are the ones which is going to decide, do you want this tank or you don't want this tank. For me, in my opinion, it is completely fine tank, and a quick comparison, this against the T-44 100, right, which is probably the closest competitor to this vehicle. And looking into the DPM difference, as you can see, DPM is pretty much the same, and remember, this tank do not have improved equipment over there, so probably it would be the same DPM, just this tank probably will have more armor on the turret and just tiny touch shitter gun handling. So once again, I try to provide you with as much information as I could, fellas, in this half hour, and I hope you enjoyed your daily dose of skill. If you did, remember to motivate us with the Kylers with a big fat thumbs up. And fellas, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, I almost forgot, happy birthday, Kylers. You thought I'm going to forget it. It's 5 in the morning and I would never ever forget it. So let's have the comment section down below floated with the Kylers, and feel free to say some good words. He's a great friend, and he is a great help for us for sure, right, fellas? He's the one which is kicking my butt and saying, "Skill, you forgot something," and I'm saying, "Yes, Dad," and I'm making a YouTube video. Anyways, thank you so much for everything, fellas. That was your daily dose of skill, and see you very, very soon. Peace.